In game two, Novo, standing carry, Thugonomics going to be charging out here, taking control of the bridge. The gateway does go down there from Bluckstack. He's going to trinket that immediately. He's going to use that pet sack as well after throwing out his MCS. Gets down the port. Demon Soul going up here as well. Looking at Danny Carey a little bit. Danny Carey into the root. We see full Demon Soul dots out on everyone here. Haunt coming out on Thugonomics. The shock miss there by Novo. So he's even dotting up Zwen, which they actually killed off last time, which is an interesting choice. Takes a bit of committing to do, but Zwen does do a lot of damage, so maybe worthwhile. Tremor going to be used there by Novos onto Danny Carey. Dematerialize going to proc as well, as he does get stunned by that Shadow Fury. Bluckstack, though, just going to hop on down, and Thugonomics now going to have to look for a new target. You don't really want to chase that Warlock down there, so he's just going to make a swap over onto Swapsie.
Yeah, he's doing as much damage as he can to Swapsie right now. I don't know that Swapsie's in too much danger at this particular moment in time. In fact, he's swapping back onto Bluckstack at this point. This is a great map, too, for both comps, really. Both Danny Carey and Bluckstack will be able to port all over the place, and plus Botar with the symbiosis.
Damage on the Bluckstack. He got in a little bit of trouble there. He actually does have to gate out, and I mean, he does use his healing cooldowns. Thugonomics decides now is the time to chase, but we're going to be able to see that port, you know, in just a couple seconds. There it is, Bluckstack porting back up top. He's going to relay his gateway. I like this choice. That's a much better gate that he did, just kind of upgrading that gate for himself. And Danny Carey still sitting with both the trinket and the will available. And, you know, do you think we're going to go long once again? You know, we could be heading down that road.
Yeah, I mean, this is definitely a map that you can go long on just because of the amount of ways that you can get away from someone on this particular map. So, especially, like I was saying, with these two teams, Bluckstack and Botarg will both be able to port to the Demonic Circle. Danny Carey will be able to use Transcendence to port around the place. Obviously, Thugonomics can use Heroic Leap. It's definitely a map that's very much in favor of those sort of mobile comps, which I believe both of these guys really are, or both of these teams are really going to be able to use to their advantage.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, they both have Thunderstorm. They can knock each other off, but Botarg going to be... Oh my god, look at that damage coming on! Wow. Thugonomics gets down about 50k. Life Cocoon has to go up. He has no shield wall either, so you know Thugonomics working through all those defensive. There's the clone onto Danny Carey. They're going to be able to sit it, but look at Novos. Danny Carey may fall a little bit behind here, and you can see him spending quite a bit of mana again. There's the NS coming out. NS clone onto Thugonomics there. You know, on that trinket proc, trying to shut down the damage, maybe try to free them up a little bit to get the CC that they do so badly need. And we are going to have Bluckstack once again. Offensive Ring of Peace comes out onto him. He's trying to get away a little bit, trying to keep that damage up. Bloodhorde going to be reflected there by Thugonomics. Uses the AoE reflect at the same time. Die by the sword going up, but he's still at full HP. You know, we talked about some of the cooldown usage. It may come back to haunt him. I mean, he has no wall now. He doesn't have no life cocoon, and Die by the sword being used a little bit needlessly there. We do see Demon's Soul being popped here by Bluckstack. Trinket comes out from him as well. Wants to stay offensive. The Shadow Fear going to go down there. Knock back on that Fear, though, from Novos, shutting that down. We see Danny Carey, though, getting low on mana. Bluckstack taking a lot of damage. We'll look at Novos. He's dipping down. Everyone's spiking pretty hard here as Botar has his heart of the wild pop. He's trying to get involved here. He's actually hurricaning the whole team right now. And that's pretty unique. And we do see Shaman Rage has to be popped here by Novos. He's going to use his Rachel as well. He wants to turn the pressure around here, but the Heart of the Wild has now expired, and that was really what put them ahead here. Danny Carey going to use that last stand, you know, with the monks. He's popping that little mini shield wall last stand there. Thugonomics now popping all his cooldowns, but he's going to be rooted on it. He doesn't have an intervene. He's deciding not to trinket. He does have a wreck and everything up there, but he's just going to be knocked off. Frustrating moment for Thugonomics there, as he's not able to get much done here. Botar now, he's the one going for the drink. He wants to get back to full mana, and I think this time around they're not going to make the same mistake. I think as they get Danny Carey low on mana, they're just going to commit. They're going to chase in. And we see Novos coming out of the Hex, catches the Tiger's Lust, as Thugonomics is going to be feared off. But he Zerker Rages into the clone, and now once again going to trinket.
Yeah, Danny Carey did actually get a second to drink in there for a second, and he is starting to get those charges of Manatee up again. I think Danny Carey may actually have some sort of drinking problem. It just seems to be something he's doing like every 3 seconds.
He's an addict, man, but sometimes that's what wins the games, man. You gotta do what works. Botar here isn't cat form. I'm not sure if he's looking for a meme exactly or what, but he was using that dash at least. Trinket gonna be up here for Bluckstack. He's gonna be put into the shockwave. The swap gonna come over onto him. Thugonomics taking a little bit of damage. You know, they're pulling him into these awkward spots where Swapsie is just kind of allowed to just tunnel out damage onto him, which is honestly, you know, a pretty good decision here. But they are going to swap back onto Swapsie. We see Zwen still active. He's going to get knocked back down. His trinket is up there. We see the Lava Surge coming in. Novos, you know, way ahead on mana. I'm not sure, you know, if this is just better Thunderstorm usage or if Swapsie's having heal more or something like that. But Danny Carey once again going for the drink, but they're going to stop him this time. You know, he gets about 10k, not bad, but not even close to how bad it was last time. And yeah. Bluckstack has the Demon Soul up. Dematerialize has proc. Thugonomics into the Fear. He's going to get the Zerker Rage out of that. Danny Carey rolling back up top after the knockoff. You can see that monk mobility in action, but there's that NS clone coming out on Danny Carey. What can they get done here? Damage is spreading around on everyone, but no one dipping down too low. We see that there is that para coming out. He tries to go for the pummel. We did have the trinket coming out from Novos, who wants us to stay offensive here onto Botar. down below. There's a Shockwave offensive ring of peace, unfortunately, overlapped onto that, so they're not going to have that to follow it up, and there goes Thugonomics into the root. He's going to intervene Banner out of that. Novos, though, taking some damage, and Botar just ports up to safety.
Yeah, Novos was taking a whole bunch of damage there. Danny Carey actually took quite a bit as well, was able to heal himself back up, but the Thugonomics chasing all over there, it looks a little scary for a second. I believe Thugonomics was actually underneath the bridge while both Novos and Danny Carey were on top, and that's the sort of positioning that can lose you games on Blade's Edge.
Definitely can, man. One miscommunication can cost you the game. As we've seen, you know, both these teams put out some massive bursts. The shot comes in from Swapsy on Novus. He's going to get knocked down to the bottom of the bridge. We see that DR clone on Danny Carey is going to be sitting. Thugonomics almost has his trinket back up. He is in the Shadow Fury, taking a little bit of damage, but nothing to worry about. But now, this is the time they need to push. Danny Carey, low on mana. They're actually going to interrupt that manatee, which is pretty nice. He's going to get spam feared out here. Doesn't have his trinket, doesn't have his will, but he has to use Aura Mastery. And look at his mana. He's very, very low. He pops another manatee. Going to get quite a bit back there, actually spamming those manatees. Unfortunately, they're not going to be able to stop any of that yet. Actually gets about 150k back right in the row. Now he's going to sit down
in the
middle.
Just sit down and drink right in the middle of everything right there. We are getting to the 6-minute mark now, so dampening is active, and it's going to be at around, I believe that's around 12% at this point. So it is going to start to become a factor, especially with how much Danny Carey's actually been having to use his mana even more this time around. I feel like he's being bled dry even more by Bleach Bones in this particular match.
Definitely is. We see the Tiger's Lust going to be used there by Danny Carey, trying to get in there, get some CC off, but not really able to do so just yet. The offensive clone coming in on Novos, trying to deny those heals. Thugonomics will be topped back off. Danny Carey getting a little bit low once again. He's going to pop that manatee. It's hard to tell, you know, how many stacks he really does have. He has some available. I'm not quite sure really how many stacks he has in the bank, but look at Bluckstack here taking a ton of damage. Jade Lightning's coming out here, being spammed out onto Bluckstack, and Bluckstack getting pretty low, going to jump back down. Zuan was out there as well. Danny Carey getting offensive. His Thugonomics did have all his cooldowns up. Reckless is going to expire there, so is the Skull Banner. You see he's just going to leap back onto the Warlock, that fantastic mobility, but Bluckstack popping the heals, going to jump right back up. Can Swapsy knock him down? Doesn't look like it just yet, and we do have that offensive friggin' piece once again, going to be able to put that Blanket Silence down. The instant Zerker Rage coming out from Thugonomics, trying to stick to that wall. But Capstun going to land on him, and he's going to try to be knocked off by Swapsy. Unfortunately, unable to land that, but, you know, still peeling pretty well here for his Warlock.
Yeah, for sure. There was actually, Novo's taking a whole bunch of damage there for a second, but does pop back up real quick. Danny Carey has been really, really good with keeping his people topped off in this whole thing. There was actually an amazing thunderstorm that I wanted to point out that happened from Swapsy just a moment ago in the midst of all that burst when Danny Carey was using his Jade Lightning as well as his Jade Tiger to try and do some extra damage. It was pretty slick. But that was then. This is now.
Here's the mana. He's going for those drinks, man. Just sitting down. And he's going to get a lot here. He may actually go to full.
Wow.
I think he is just pretty much coming back with full mana. Botar, same time, though, also going for the drink here, is going to be able to get back almost to full. But, I mean, he was at 200k. He went to 250. Danny Carey was at, like, what, like 80?
Yeah,
80,
he was
and he
so
went to 250.
Low.
So, you know, it's just the theme, man. They just need to choose that time and commit to it. I really, really feel, you know, they're doing everything right. You know, to get to that position where they're ahead, but then they're just not able to close it out just yet. And I guess it just, you know, obviously credit where credit is due as well. Novus and Thugonomics are doing a great job peeling them away and making it hard for them to stop those drinks.
Yeah, I mean, we talk a lot about how they need to be interrupting those drinks as much as possible, but like you were saying earlier, it's not that easy. It really isn't, especially against a monk. I mean, you've got two rolls and a transcendence. You can get yourself in a good position.
The ascendance coming out, though. They're going to be going offensive. Looks like Thugonomics is the target of choice. When you see that, he's spamming out those lava bursts. There's the bash on Thugonomics. He has to trinket it. Parry comes up as well. Will it be enough? And the life cocoon coming out there also. So he's down at 200k. He's stacking some of those defensives. You know, he used parry, used life cocoon, used trinket. So they did get some of that going. And Bluckstack has his demon soul up. When you see them pushing forward, there's the clone on Danny Carey. Instant trinket comes out. CS on the Novos. They're trying to get this kind of a cross CC going. The 3v1 on Thugonomics. Will it be able to work? Heart of the Wild coming back up here as well from Botar. The early heart's really paying off for him. The orbs is being spammed down though on the Thugonomics. He's going to be able to top back off. And Botar spending a lot of mana getting offensive there. But once again, Danny Carey, he's the one behind on mana. We see the para coming out onto Bluckstack. Going to be able to shut down a little bit of his damage. Barkskin having to use there by Botar. But Thugonomics getting spiked down low. And there's the Shadow Fury coming in. Dematerialize comes out. Can they follow that up? He's going for the manatee. And spamming out those orbs once again, just going to be able to heal Thugonomics back up, but they're all caught by that mass entangling, which was a fantastic job there by Botar. And we did see Windwalk Totem going to be thrown down by Novus, and look at Thugonomics just getting knocked a mile away there.
Yeah, in the middle of that, Danny Carey actually made the choice to use Manatee instead of healing Thugonomics at like 20% health. It's a very tough choice to make as a healer, but it was definitely the right one in this particular case. Thugonomics is not dead, which is exactly what he wants at this particular point in time.
That's something you definitely do want, man. 20k mana there on Danny Carey. Gonna pop the manatees, though, spamming them out, getting back to 100. So it's really hard to tell exactly where he's sitting on mana. There's the offensive ring of peace off of that that shockwave. Botar just pops Barks and goes back down. He's gonna have Cenarion ward up. He's gonna be healing himself back up. So they are sitting pretty right now, but we're at the 10 minute mark. That means we have added 30% healing reduction into this game with dampening, and it's gonna start being harder and harder. And you see, for the first time in this game, pretty much Botar is actually the one behind on mana. So, you know, it seems to just be a little bit of a losing battle here for this LSD as time goes on. But Innervate, he does come back up. He's going to be able to get a good amount of mana back here. But you see, he's just having to use regrowth upon regrowth now because the HOTS are just no longer enough at this point with dampening MS.
Yeah, for sure. It's definitely going to get very, very hard to start keeping people alive, especially when Bluckstack is taking as much damage as he is right now.
There's the NS clone on that all the cooldowns there. He tried to get the Reflect up, but it was just a little bit too late, unfortunately. And Bluckstack going to be taking a ton of damage as a result.
Yeah. Does have that Dark Regen up, and he did manage to drop down a Demonic Circle up over there. He should be able to port up over there to safety, but he's taking... There it is. There's the port. Getting up over there to safety, but does get stunned, taking even more damage now from Thugonomics. Getting very, very low, but does manage to get away again.
Yeah, and a nice bash on the Thugonomics. They're going to try to turn it around. Die by the Sword popped right away by Thugonomics there. Botar down about 30k mana, and there's that Heroic Leaf just right on top of the Warlock as he come out of the gateway. He's already there. Bluckstack just running out of cooldowns here. They're running on fumes here, man. There's not much left. I don't know how much longer they can really survive here. They need to make something happen. Danny Carey just always having those manatees ready when he needs it. Thugonomics gonna chase that down, but we see the port up comes from Bluckstack. Bluckstack, though, getting dangerously low. Swaps, he's gonna be pummeled there by Danny Carey. Hal comes out on him. He's gonna sit through it. He has Will and Trinket, deciding not to use either, though. Nova's gonna be MCS. Bluckstack down about 200k, needs a tap as well. And Botar is just, ooh, man, he's got nothing. We do see the Tranquility coming out. That's gonna be interrupted. And Bluckstack just trying desperately to get away, trying to get that counter pressure, because if they can't get control of this game soon, they're just simply going to not be able to catch back up.
Mm-hmm, yeah. By the way, I'm going to bet in like half a second Danny Carey is going to drink again.
He's definitely going to try for it, man. He's getting low mana, but this could be a good opportunity. No, the bash comes in. Bluckstack decides he just needs to get out of there. He can't risk going for the damage right now. And Botar going to be paralyzed. He is going to be able to get after his Warlock right now, but they have caught back up. Shield will actually pop pretty preemptively here by Thugonomics. Maybe that is because Danny Carey's going for a drink. No, it doesn't look like it.
Yeah,
so
he did actually start drinking, but it was interrupted by an Entangling Roots, which is an interesting trick.
Oh, there's the clone. It's going to have to be trinketed. Oh, reclones his trinket. A nice shot there by Botar. Thugonomics could be in some trouble here. Does not have that parry. Should have no wall either for quite a long time as it just expires. So I think he has the last stand, but that's about it. If they can get some CC out on Danny Carey, perhaps they could finish off Thugonomics as the Shadow Fury comes in. Haunt's going to land. Botar getting a little bit of mana back there. Do you see that fear onto Danny Carey? It's going to be tremored a little bit late. The knockoff just missing by an inch there on Thugonomics. And we see Danny Carey rotting a lot here. Botar just somehow, some way, keeping his team alive through damning MS. Just insane play from him. We have Thugonomics, though, in hot pursuit. There's the shockwave coming out. Instant trinket by Bluckstack. Bluckstack trying to do his best, trying to stay away from him. This swap comes out on Botar. He's going to pop the barks in. He's going to displace his out of there. Now he's going to pour back up. There's the port. Nice play from him, avoiding as much damage as possible. We see the last stand pop by Danny Carey. He's going to be down about 3k mana right now. Looks like he has no manatee as well. He just got one manatee, but that's it, man. So if they can stay alive, they could actually finish off this game. Here comes the Shadow Fury. Thugonomics in some trouble. Danny Carey's tapped on mana. Literally hit zero mana right there. Nova's in the clone. They just need to get their pressure out. They need the full dots up. Bluckstack has his trinket pop. Can he get the damage rolling here? If they can get some CC on Danny Carey, this could be it. He has no trinket left, and they are definitely in a pretty good position here, but at the same time, Swapsy having to pop the Shaman Rage. Iron Bark comes up as well. Thugonomics being pressured, but you know that D-stance, that passive damage reduction coming in huge for him as well. Bloodbath going to be popped. Orc Racial going up here for Thugonomics, trying to keep the damage rolling onto Bluckstack, who once again just boom. And look at that spike coming in on Swapsy. Swapsy going to get so low from Novos. May be able to just finish Swapsy off. If we look, he's so low. We have the healing tied out here, but Botar's still going to paralyze. And is it going to be enough? Look at the damage, though, coming around back on Thugonomics.
Yeah, Swapsy is so close to dead. So many people so close to dead. We are just about to hit the 14-minute mark, which means there is just over 1 minute remaining for the timeout in this match. This is going to be intense in this last few seconds.
This
could
be a no block stack caught in the shockwave. He's at 100k HP. I don't think they're going to be able to top him back off. He needs to get out of there. He needs to kite away. Can they turn this around and kill off Thugonomics? It would be incredible if they could do so, but the charge comes in. Blockstack, there's just nothing left in the tank for Botar. He's going to be feared off. The Tremor comes out instantly from Swapsy there. We see that Danny Carey's still low on mana, but they're the team with the pressure. They're the team with the momentum. Some big damage coming in on Thugonomics, so he's down to 150k, 140k, but Bluckstack sitting low as well. Last stand comes out from Thugonomics. Can Bluckstack get out of there? Looks like he can for now. Heart of the Wild coming up. Botar just going to go offensive. He says, screw it. He's spamming out the Moonfires. Thugonomics, the last stand's going to fall. Thugonomics goes down. with 30 seconds remaining. And Bloxzak, there could be a cross kill. Bloxzak could go down here. The healing is almost non-existent at this point. The clone comes in on Novos. He still could die, guys. There's nothing left for Botar. He has Heart of the Wild.
He's got to live for another 10 seconds.
Yeah, there's 10 seconds remaining. I think he's going to be able to survive. He just needs to get a little bit away. The Crackling Jade Lightning's still coming out, but it's not going to be enough. What a close one. And PvP Live. They